So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. So guys, Friday and Monday ka session could not be conducted because I was on the leave, but you guys don't worry, every news which have been left during these days will be covered in upcoming 3-4 days, right? So session ab hoga Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and in those sessions I will cover all the news which have been left. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming in for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you can ask your doubts and you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask anything related to examinations. Alright, so let's talk about the very first question, which is, guys, the very, very important question. In any upcoming exam, this question will definitely be asked. अगर आने वाले एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन नहीं आता है तो वो क्वेश्चन पेपर बेकार है, एग्जामिनर को क्वेश्चन बनाना नहीं आता है, इसका मतलब, ठीक है? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द क्वेश्चन. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू स्कीम फॉर इकोनॉमिक एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ डीएनटीज. डीएनटी स्टैंड्स फॉर डी नोटिफाइड ट्राइब्स एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. सो दिस इज अ वेरी ब्रांड न्यू स्कीम लॉन्च बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट, राइट? एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट विल बी डेफिनेटली आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जाम. So let's talk about the scheme then. So remember, the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Tikamgarh. Alright, he is MP from Tikamgarh. So this ministry has launched Scheme for Economic Empowerment of DNTs, which in short is SEED. Now remember the objective of this scheme. Ye kyun launch kiya gaya hai? What is the objective behind launching this scheme? So the objective is the holistic development of denotified nomadic and semi-nomadic tribes. जो हमारे देश की denotified tribes हैं, nomadic tribes हैं और semi-nomadic tribes हैं, उनके holistic development के लिए this scheme has been launched. Now, before moving ahead to the discussion of this scheme, what is the meaning of DNT? Denotified tribes का मतलब क्या होता है? Remember, denotified tribes, these are the tribes which were notified once under the Criminal Tribes Act. Under the Criminal Tribes Act, and this act was enforced by the British Raj during a period of 1871 to 1947. All right, so these are the tribes which were once notified under the Criminal Tribes Act, which was enforced by the British Raj during a period of 1871 to 1947. But after independence, Government of India repealed this act, and since then these tribes are known as denotified tribes. All right. So I hope DNT का मतलब clear है. And one more extra information you should know, that in the year 2014, the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment had constituted a national commission for the welfare of DNTs, nomadic tribes and semi-nomadic tribes. And this committee was chaired by Mr. Bhikkhu Ramji. Bhikkhu Ramji was the chairperson of this commission, all right? And this committee submitted its report in the year 2017, and on the basis of recommendation of this committee, is commission ki recommendation ke basis pe, in the year 2019, a development and welfare board for DNTs, nomadic tribes and semi-nomadic tribes was established, all right? So, ये थोड़ी बहुत इन्फॉर्मेशन है, आपको पता होनी चाहिए. दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जाम. नाउ लेट्स टॉक मोर अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम. सो रिमेंबर, इट हैज बीन लॉन्च दिस ईयर, दैट इज इन द ईयर 2022, एंड इट विल बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड अप टू द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2026. फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2026 तक ये चलेगा. वट इज द टोटल आउटले? इट इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली ₹200 करोड़. रिमेंबर, इट इज अप्रॉक्सीमेट अमाउंट, इट कैन ऑल्सो बी इंक्रीज्ड और डिक्रीज्ड, राइट? Who are eligible to get the benefit under this particular scheme or program, you can say? All DNT families, all nomadic tribe families and all semi-nomadic tribe families having annual income equal to or less than 2.5 lakh per annum. Jo annual income hai, wo 2.5 lakh ke barabar ya usse kam hogi agar, then the families will be eligible, provided that they are not getting benefit from any similar government scheme. Kisi aur agar similar government scheme se unko benefit mil raha hai, then they will not be eligible to get the benefits. Remember, the scheme will be implemented through a portal which has been developed by the Department of Social Justice and Empowerment. Ek portal hoga, uske through sara data collect hoga and all the benefits will be provided to the beneficiaries and implementing agencies other than the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. These are the other implementing agency. Of course, it is being implemented by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment in collaboration with Ministry of Rural Development, National Health Authority and National Rural Livelihood Mission. Alright. Now the objective was the holistic development. Objective kya tha? Holistic development of the DNTs, of the nomadic tribes and the SNTs. But how this holistic development will be done? Kaise hoga ye? So there are four different components of this particular scheme through which this development will be done. Number one is the free coaching. Number one kya hai? Free coaching. Free coaching for what? So remember, free coaching for competitive examination will be provided to the DNT, NT and SNT candidates. Competitive examination chahe engineering ka hai, chahe medical ka hai, chahe kisi government exam ka hai. So the free coaching will be provided to the candidates belonging to DNT, NTs and SNT community. 6,250 students will be provided free coaching in the upcoming 5 year, jo iska implementation period hai 5 saal ka, and the total amount spent will be rupees 50 crores. 50 crore rupees spent kiye jayenge under on this component. Number two is the health insurance. Health insurance will be provided under the ambit of Ayushman Bharat Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana ke under health insurance provide karaya jayega 5 lakh per family. Rupees 5 lakh per family health insurance will be provided, and for this financial assistance will be provided to the National Health Authority, which is the implementing agency for Ayushman Bharat Yojana. Theek hai? So National Health Authority will be provided financial assistance. 4,44,500 families belonging to these communities will get the benefit, and the total amount that will be spent on this component is rupees how much? 49 crores. Then livelihood opportunities will be provided, and for that financial assistance will be provided to the National Rural Livelihood Missions. And National Rural Livelihood Mission in collaboration with State Rural Livelihood Mission will provide the employment opportunities to the people of these communities. Alright. And remember, 2000 clusters will be benefited in the upcoming 5 years, and the total amount spent on this component will be how much? Rupees 49 crores. And finally, of course, housing. अब देखो, रोटी कपड़ा और मकान सब कुछ जरूरी है, तो रोटी मिल जाएगी लाइवलीहुड अपॉर्चुनिटी से, कपड़ा भी उससे मिल जाएगा, मकान देना भी जरूरी है. सो मकान कैसे मिलेगा? थ्रू द प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना. सो हाउसिंग सपोर्ट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड अंडर प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना. ऑलराइट. एंड हाउसिंग सपोर्ट कैसे मिलता है प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना में? हाउ द हाउसिंग सपोर्ट इज प्रोवाइडेड अंडर प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना. सो सर्टेन अमाउंट इज प्रोवाइडेड to the beneficiaries for construction of their own house. Alright. And similarly, in plain areas, the DNTs, NTs and SNTs communities will get rupees 1.20 lakh. ठीक है? In the hilly areas, they will get rupees 1.30 lakh, 1,30,000. Total 4,200 houses will be constructed in the upcoming 5 years. And the total amount spent on this component will be rupees 50 crores. Alright, so these are the four components through which the holistic development of these community will be done through this particular scheme, jiska naam hai SEED. Alright. Now let's come back to the question. I hope the scheme is clear. You have to identify the correct statement. The total outlay for the scheme is rupees 500 crore. Is that so? No. It is rupees 200 crore. Kitna hai? 200 crore hai. It has been launched up to financial year 2027. Nahin, 2027 nahin. It has been launched up to financial year 2026. All DNT, NT and SNT families having annual income equal to or less than rupees 2.5 lakhs are eligible. Absolutely correct. Koi dikkat nahi hai isme. And rupees 1.20 lakh will be provided to beneficiaries in plain areas for construction of houses. So, ye bhi bilkul sahi hai. And remember, in the hilly areas, this amount is how much? Rupees 1.30 lakhs. So 3 and 4 are correct, which means option D, only 3 and 4 will be the correct answer. So I hope this question is clear. Now let's move ahead to question number 2, which is again a very important question, a brand new launch scheme by the government of India. So again, there is a huge chance of this question being asked in your exam. Okay, definitely exam mein aayega. So which of the following statements is incorrect? Now you have to identify incorrect statement with respect to New India Literacy Program approved by the government of India. So this is a new program which has been approved by Government of India under the New Education Policy 2020, एंड इज नेम्ड एज व्हाट? न्यू इंडिया लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम. सो नाम से ही पता चल रहा है इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम है ये. ठीक है, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस प्रोग्राम. सो रिमेंबर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज अप्रूव्ड दिस प्रोग्राम न्यू इंडिया लिटरेसी अंडर द न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी 2020 एंड रिमेंबर इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अप टू द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2027. ठीक है, कब तक के लिए लॉन्च किया है? 2027 तक के लिए. एंड व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव? ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू इम्पार्ट फाउंडेशनल लिटरेसी एंड न्यूमरेसी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाउंडेशनल लिटरेसी एंड न्यूमरेसी विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एंड आफ्टर दैट क्रिटिकल लाइफ स्किल्स. नाउ व्हाट विल बी कवर्ड अंडर द हेडिंग ऑफ क्रिटिकल लाइफ स्किल्स? सो द बेनिफिशियरीज विल प्रोवाइड डिजिटल लिटरेसी. ठीक है, जो कि आज के डेट में बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है. दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी. ठीक है, दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ यू नो एजुकेशन, बेनिफिट्स ऑफ हेल्थ. ये सारी चीजें उनको प्रोवाइड कराई जाएगी अंडर द क्रिटिकल लाइफ स्किल्स. वोकेशनल स्किल्स विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एंड बेसिक एंड कंटिन्यूइंग एजुकेशन विल ऑल्सो बी प्रोवाइडेड एज पर द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ न्यू इंडिया लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम. रिमेंबर द लॉन्च ईयर इज 2022 एंड इट विल बी कंटिन्यूड अप टू फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2027. द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग मिनिस्ट्री इज ऑफकोर्स द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर धर्मेंद्र प्रधान हु इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. मूविंग अहेड टू द एलिजिबिलिटी. सो रिमेंबर ऑल इलिटरेट्स, जितने भी इलिटरेट्स हैं ऑफ एज 15 ईयर्स एंड अबव इन ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज. ठीक है, ये सारे स्टेट्स और यूटीज के लिए है. टू फॉर ऑल दोज हु आर इलिटरेट्स एंड हैविंग एज 15 ईयर्स और अबव. ऑलराइट, द टारगेट इज टू ट्रेन 5 crore लर्नर्स एट 1 crore पर ईयर. एक साल में 1 crore लोगों को इसमें लर्निंग दी जाएगी एंड टोटल 5 crore का टारगेट है. एंड द ट्रेनिंग विल बी प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू ऑटलेस. व्हाट इज दिस ऑटलेस? इट इज ऑनलाइन टीचिंग लर्निंग एंड असेसमेंट सिस्टम. ऑनलाइन टीचिंग लर्निंग एंड असेसमेंट सिस्टम. थ्रू दिस सिस्टम द ट्रेनिंग विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द बेनिफिशियरी इन कोलैबोरेशन विद नेशनल इंफॉर्मेटिक सेंटर NCERT एंड नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग. ठीक है, and total outlay is 1037.90 crore and out of this much amount central government will provide 700 crore and the rest 337.90 crore will be borne by the state governments. All right, so now let's come back to the question. Itna hi padhna hai isme, isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. You have to identify the incorrect statement. It has been launched up to financial year 2027. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 5 crore learners will be benefited by this scheme. Bilkul sahi baat hai. All illiterates of age 18 years and above in all states and UTs. नहीं, not 18 years, it is 15 years. All right, 15 years. So option C will be the correct answer because we have to identify the incorrect statement. All right. So I hope guys this question is also clear. Moving ahead to question number 3. Now अब जो बाकी questions हैं उसमें ज़्यादा कुछ detail नहीं है. छोटे-छोटे question हैं. जल्दी से पढ़ लेते हैं, ख़त्म कर लेते हैं. जो पहले के दो questions थे बहुत ही ज़्यादा important हैं. पक्का आएंगे exam में. How many multimodal logistic parks are targeted to be developed under PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan? So as you all know, PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan is nothing but an umbrella scheme, an umbrella program under which the integrated planning and collaboration for all the infrastructure projects is being done. Jitne bhi hamare infrastructure project desh mein chal rahe the, un sab ko kya kara? एक अम्ब्रेला स्कीम, एक अम्ब्रेला प्रोग्राम, एक अम्ब्रेला प्रोग्राम प्लान के अंदर डाल दिया जिसका नाम रखा पीएम गति शक्ति. एंड इट वाज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2021 में इसको लॉन्च किया था. एंड इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी की बात करें तो नेशनल हाईवे अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया, नेशनल हाईवे एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन एंड नेशनल हाईवे लॉजिस्टिक मैनेजमेंट लिमिटेड. ठीक है, दीज आर द 3 इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी फॉर पीएम गति शक्ति नेशनल मास्टर प्लान. नाउ why it is in news? Because the government has announced that they are going to construct, that they are going to you know make these various projects under this plan. And these are 22 greenfield expressways will be constructed, 23 other key infrastructure projects and other highway projects, and the very important 35 multimodal logistic parks will be constructed under the PM Gati Shakti plan. All right, so these 3 data are very important. Do remember this: 22 greenfield expressways, 23 other key infrastructure projects and other highway projects, and 35 multimodal logistic parks will be established. So come back to the question then. 35 is the correct answer because the question is regarding multimodal logistic parks. So 35 multimodal logistic parks will be established under PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan. Moving ahead to question number 4, name the program organized by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. R.K. Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is what? Ara. And Ara is in Bihar and he is also the Minister of Power. To discuss various aspects of energy transition and climate action and to prepare a roadmap to achieve net zero carbon emission by the year 2070. So I hope you all know this. Prime Minister of India, Prime Minister Modi announced the Panchamrit, the 5 targets which they are calling as Panchamrit during the COP26, COP26 mein. ये 5 टारगेट गवर्नमेंट ने अनाउंस किए थे, प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने अनाउंस किए थे, एंड आउट ऑफ दोज 5 टारगेट्स 1 टारगेट इज टू अचीव नेट जीरो कार्बन एमिशन बाय द ईयर 2070. ठीक है, सो उसी को डिस्कस करने के लिए दिस प्रोग्राम वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी. एंड रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम इज न्यू फ्रंटियर्स प्रोग्राम, न्यू फ्रंटियर्स प्रोग्राम. एंड एज द क्वेश्चन ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट it was launched to discuss various aspects of energy transition and climate action and to discuss a roadmap on how we can achieve the net zero carbon emission by the year 2070. Remember, an event was organized which is titled as India's Leadership in Energy Transition at Vigyan Bhavan under this program, and 3 different webinars were conducted. 3 alag alag webinars hue the which are not important for exam. This is just for the basic understanding that what all have been done under this program. So, 3 webinar hue the. Number 1 is Women in RE, Renewable Energy Call for Action, Role of International Solar Alliance in Energy Transition, and Role of Clean Tech Startups and Climate Entrepreneur in Providing Clean and Affordable Energy. So, in this particular question, you just have to remember the name of the program, New Frontiers Program. Agar question aaya to wo yahi hoga jo yahan pe likha hua hai. So, therefore, the correct answer is what? New Frontiers, option B will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5, name the initiative launched under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban which is aimed to discuss and disseminate learnings and knowledge on housing in urban spaces. Now let me clarify this, ki ye koi naya initiative nahi hai. This is not a new initiative, it is in news because recently a meeting under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban was conducted, and in that particular meeting this was discussed, this initiative was discussed, and that's why this question is here. So this initiative, remember, was launched last year in the year 2021 to discuss and disseminate learnings and knowledge on housing in urban spaces. And remember, the name of the initiative is what? Awas Par Samvad. Awas Par Samvad is the name of initiative which was launched last year, of course, by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. So option A is the correct answer. So now let's talk about question number 6, which is the last question for today. With which country government of India and Australia have conducted an international workshop to address marine pollution with a focus on plastic debris? Theek hai, marine pollution ke upar discussion karne ke liye this international workshop was conducted by government of India in collaboration with government of Australia and Singapore. Option C is the correct answer. And in this particular news, we do not have to go into the details because that is not required. ठीक है, हर टॉपिक को उसकी औकात के हिसाब से पढ़ना चाहिए, उसकी औकात से ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है, because that way you will just waste your time. Alright. So that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear, and rest of the news, I assure you कि मैं सारा complete कर दूंगा. जितना भी pending है, everything will be provided in the upcoming sessions. Alright. So thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.